To the News Minute. I'm Dhanya Rajendran, joining your reporters from all across Bengaluru. You can hear the sounds behind me. That's a celebration breaking out in the BJP office in Karnataka. The BJP has taken a comfortable lead. They've in fact crossed 100 as of now. The leads that we have now is the BJP is at 107, which of course means that they are just 6 to 7 seats short of the magic number. Remember, only 222 seats have gone into polls now this time, because two seats, Rajarajeshwari Nagar and Jaya Nagar, did not go into polls. So 222 seats, the magic number. BJP already has 107 seats leads. The leads should be maintained is what we are expecting. The Congress doing much worse than they expected. They are having leads at 67 seats. The JDS, of course, doing much better than 2013 when they won to only 40 seats. Imagine, this is the party which everyone thought is slowly disintegrating, is slowly becoming oblivious. But the JDS has made a comeback, winning more seats than last time. From 40, it looks like the JDS may get at least 45. That's the leads for now. I'm quickly going to go across to Manasa and Shomoy, my colleagues from the BJP office. Look at the celebrations there. Hundreds of BJP workers gathered, saying, chanting slogans about Bharat Mata, Modi and B.S. Yeddurappa. Celebrations breaking out at the BJP office. Shomoy and Manasa, tell us what's happening there.
That's right, Dhanya. It's absolutely jubilant here at the BJP office. And like you said, the BJP has comfortably crossed the, you know, the 100-seat mark. And there are large cutouts of Prime Minister Modi. Amit Shah, in fact, who parked himself in Bengaluru for over 2 weeks, 3 weeks. And, you know, he is seen as the force behind winning the election for the BJP. And for Karnataka, he's largely credited with paying attention to each and every district, especially, you know, Dakshin Karnataka, where, the BJP is seen as being the strongest cadre, in fact, breaking out into song and dance. And there are chants of, in favor of Yeddurappa, the BJP's chief ministerial candidate, but the main focus here is Modi, and chanting the name of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and it's absolutely jubilant, carrying flags of the BJP in Karnataka, and everybody is gathered here.
Manasa, if I can just ask Shomo, who are the BJP leaders in the party office now, or are more leaders going to B.S. Yeddurappa's house?
Former Chief Minister D.B. Sadanand Gowda here in the office, as among the top leaders. He found a minute earlier he was speaking about the discipline of the party, how it has changed since Amit Shah took over as a national president, and he says that there is no divide in the party, and B.S. Yeddurappa is going to be the Chief Minister if the party emerges as the single largest MLG as it wins as of now.
Well, so that is Shomo and Manasa giving us the visuals from the BJP office. They're of course standing on one of the floors. That's the BJP office in Bengaluru's Malleshwaram. There are celebrations breaking out. BJP leaders chanting the name of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. This is a man who has visited many constituencies. He's had a whirlwind of rallies in Karnataka, and many believe that he is the one who's really turned around for the fortune of the BJP. Yes, the Lingayats, it looks like, have gone completely with the BJP. Anti-incumbency has worked against the Congress in many constituencies, but it is Narendra Modi, it seems, who has consolidated all these votes for the BJP and enabled them as of now to have leads in 107 seats out of 222 in Karnataka. My colleague Anna Isaac is standing at B.S. Yeddurappa's residence. Anna, what is happening there? Are there celebrations, or is B.S. Yeddurappa going to come out only after the wins are in?
Well, celebrations have been big on here at Yeddurappa's residence, Dhanya, but of course, we're expecting him to come out maybe by 11:30 or so. That is when, of course, Shobha Karandlaje said that they'll get a better sense. But Shobha Karandlaje, of course, is a BJP leader and a close aide of Yeddurappa. She's campaigned since early this morning. So is son Vijendra. They're both here. Slowly, supporters are trickling into Yeddurappa's residence here. In fact, the media as well, perhaps, were spread across different parts of of Bengaluru, they're also making their way here, expecting celebrations, expecting cars to pour in here to his residence. Just one more thing, Dhanya, before you go to another reporter. Yedrupa yesterday had told the media that he would leave for Delhi today to fix his swearing in date. Ahead of the polls, he said 17th would be the date of swearing in for him. So, of course, we'll have to wait and see as to whether 17th, in fact, remains the day but of course, we have something here.
But I think I'm losing that connection.
A BJP MLA has just come to speak to the media. Once again, get to him, Dhanya.
That is BJP MLA Ashwath Narayan speaking there. From the visuals I can see.
ಅಭಿನಂದಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೂ ಮತ್ತು ಕೃತಜ್ಞತೆಯನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನತಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಬೆಂಬಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಪಡಿಸಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನತಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿನ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿರುವಂತ ಈ ದಿನ ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಜಕ್ಕೂ ನಮಗೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನತಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತರಿಗೂ ವಾಗಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ತಿರಸ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂತದ್ದು ನಿಜಕ್ಕೂ ಬಹಳ ಸಂತೋಷದ ವಿಷಯ. ಪಕ್ಷದ
That is BJP MLA Ashwath Narayan, who is leading in his constituency, saying that they're really happy at the fact that the BJP is poised to win this election. I will now go across to Priyanka, who's standing at the house of HT Devagowda. Anna, I think you should just cut that audio now. I'm going to go to Priyanka, who's standing outside HT Devagowda's residence. Priyanka, if the BJP crosses the 100 mark, and now it does look like the party will cross the 100 mark, then the bargaining power for the JDS, which is Devagowda and Kumaraswamy, is going to come down heavily. What are people saying there?
Right now, the atmosphere here is extremely quiet. There is nobody from the JDS actually coming out here to even talk to the media. What is the people waiting here? There is no kind of celebration of any sort. Because the mood is very somber. If I can ask my camera person to this pan, if you can see on the first floor, members of the state are watching TV, waiting for the initial lead to actually become
the situation.
And as far as the numbers are concerned, we know that the BJP at this point of time seems likely to cross the 100 mark. The Congress has stuck to the 60 to 70 mark as of now, but the JDS have done as better than what expert forces predicted them to do. They seem likely to cross the 40 mark. So at this point of time, yes, it does renew their mark. We have a lot of people being concerned. But we know for a fact that Devagowda in fact told his son that if he were to partner with the BJP following this alliance, he will disown him. This is something that we must keep in mind, and HT Kumaraswamy in several interviews following this has said time and again that he will listen to what his father says and that Devagowda is in fact the boss of the party. He has repeated this over and over again and said that he will not do anything that is against his father's wishes. At this point of time, we know that the Congress is 60 something and the JDS is at a 40 something mark. If they do manage to actually come together, which also seems unlikely because we know the tie between Siddharamaiah and JDS is extremely bitter at this point of time. So what will exactly happen to the JDS? Will they remain the kingmakers that they claim to be? That is something that will come under question at this point of time, because the BJP will not need them. We saw Narendra Modi during his campaign. Initially, he had praised Devagowda's administration, but he went on to say that a vote for the JDS is a waste of your vote to the people of Karnataka. This is something he said repeatedly during his campaign. So for the BJP, as they had predicted, if they do cross and comfortably get to the simple majority mark, the JDS is of no use. But for the Congress, if they say let's say they get to about 70 seats and the JDS has 40 odd seats, the JDS will still have a likely chance to get into talks with Congress at this point in time.
Well, so that's what Priyanka is telling us from Devagowda's residence in Bangalore, that things are quiet now, nobody seems to be coming. But the numbers really that we are putting out on the News Minute, the BJP has leads in 110 seats, Priyanka, the Congress in 68 seats, the JDS in 42 seats and others in 2 seats, which means the BJP is reaching the halfway mark. Like I said, 222 seats went to polls, which is 111 if you take a half, and then one more, 112 is what they need. They're just 2 seats in short for the halfway mark. We have of course 2 more seats coming up for election. So it does look like the BJP will not even need the JDS's help. So if I've got Anna back on the, I don't think I have Anna back. Shomo, if you can hear me, what do you think has worked against the Congress? Is it anti-incumbency? Have they really made too many sitting MLAs in this election who people do not like anymore? Or do you simply think that the BJP combined with the numbers of the KJP in 2013 has surged ahead in every region in the state?
Well, Rania, as it emerges right now, seems like yes, some of the incumbent MLAs are losing their rout. Even N.A. Harris in Shantinagar, we heard, is trailing. And also the fact that what many underestimated was that the BJP was not actually 40, but if you add the KJP and the BRC numbers, it was around 84. So last time, that was not a very as rosy as look for the Congress. Right now, we see the BJP seems to be very confident in their top leadership. D.V. Sadanand Gowda is very sure of, you know, Yedurappa is becoming the chief minister. We are hearing talks of that Yedurappa will soon fly to Delhi to decide on his starting end date after a meeting with Amit Shah.
Well, B.S. Yedurappa is one man who had declared that he would be sworn in as a chief minister of Karnataka on the 17th, which is day after tomorrow. So he was very confident that the BJP will win a simple majority, and that's what it looks like now. The BJP inching towards a simple majority, or at least the BJP will definitely be in power in Karnataka with the help of a few MLAs. So, and we are looking across regions. We are talking about coastal Karnataka. We're talking about Mysore region, where the BJP seems to have made some inroads. In central Karnataka, in Mumbai, Karnataka, in many of these places, the BJP has done better. The gamble of bringing the Reddy brothers back into the BJP, like I've been saying right from the beginning, is bad optics, but it's really good politics. Now, why is it bad optics and good politics? For those who look at the elections, they will question as to why the BJP has brought tainted MLAs, ministers or the mining barons back into the party. But as far as politics is concerned, the Reddys have direct control over many seats, especially in Ballari district. And it looks like the Reddys are going to be sweeping all the 7 seats that they've been contesting from, and perhaps even more from the Ballari district. So the return of the Reddy brothers definitely has helped the BJP. The Lingayat vote seems to have come together for the BJP, which also means that Siddaramaiah's last minute gamble of giving minority status to Lingayats has not worked at all. Instead, it may even have backfired on him. We'll have to check for the last numbers. As far as regions are concerned, there was definitely anti-incumbency against many of the Congress sitting MLAs, and that's worked against the party. Shoma, just show us the visuals again of the celebrations outside the BJP office.
Yeah, as you see, so there's a huge television board out here, and the BJP supporters are celebrating. There's a chance of Modi, there's a chance of Yedurappa, there are chance of Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Absolute change of revolution. There is no doubt among the BJP supporters that they are coming to power.
Priyanka, quickly before I go, do you think there'll be any action there, or it looks like the JDS is going to be ignored now?
As
this point of time, there is not much action here. Not many MLAs even coming to the JDA's office at this point of time. As you can see behind me, if I can ask my camera person to pan, there are a couple of MLA hopefuls who have just arrived at this venue. And even when they spoke to the media, they said, obviously there is no confidence. The JDA has said that they are going to gain a majority, but at this point of time, it's clearly unlikely that they will. And therefore, for them, it's time to decide what do they want to do. The chances of a coalition with BJP seem outside the cards now, because BJP is heading towards what seems like a simple majority. So will they get in talks with the Congress, and together will they be able to have some kind of a government together, a coalition together? Will they be able to reach the numbers necessary? The halfway mark here will be 112 in order to actually, the winning number will be 112 in order to form government. Will they reach the government is the question. Right now, Kumaraswamy, however, is doing well in both the constituency that he's standing in, both in Ramnagar and Chennapatna. But for the JDS, what does the future hold? What will be their fate? Will they even get a chance to be kingmakers? That is something that remains a huge question mark.
Thank you very much to all the reporters. This actually reminds me of what happened in 2014 in Tamil Nadu, I mean during the Lok Sabha elections. I remember that Jay Jayalalitha wanted to play this really big role in the elections, and she did go ahead to win at least, I think, 38 seats in the Lok Sabha in Tamil Nadu. But finally, she could not be part of the government because the BJP could attain simple majority. That's almost the case with the JDS here. They have performed well, they have performed better when compared to 2013. But alas, H.T. Kumaraswamy and H.T. Devagowda may not be playing the role of kingmakers, because the BJP at the end of the day, it looks like, will not even be needing their help. So we will come back to you if any of the leaders are coming to speak to the media. The celebrations, of course, will also start at B.S. Yedurappa's residence in some time, and we hope that he will come out and address the media.